Hi friends, welcome to the Modern Learning. Today we are going to solve the exercises of the lesson Light in the Night. So let's get started. Here is exercise A, comprehension. We need to answer the questions. Our first question is, before street lamps were introduced, what did people do on cloudless moonlit nights? Why did they need to wait for these weather conditions? And the answer is, before street lamps were introduced, people would take advantage of the moonlight on cloudless nights and go out to socialize. If the moonlight was hidden by clouds, or if the moon was not full or nearly full, there would be no light when it was dark because there were no street lamps. Our question B is, before street lamps were introduced, what were the dangers people faced if they went out at night? And the answer is, before street lamps were introduced, the dangers that people faced if they went out at night were that they could trip, fall and injure themselves, or drown if they fell into water, or be attacked or robbed. Our question C is, who were Ling Boys and what did they do? And the answer is, the Ling Boys were young men who would, for a small fee, hold a burning torch or lamp ahead of people so that they could see the way through the dark streets. Our next question is, what did the work of the lamplighter involve? And the answer is, the lamplighters had to keep the lights clean, make sure the wicks were trimmed to the right length, light tens of lamps in the evening and put them all out again in the morning. Our next question is, roughly how many gas lamps are there in London today? In London today, there are roughly 1500 gas lamps. Our next question is, how many people are employed to light these lamps today? And the answer is that 5 people are employed to light these lamps today. Our next question is, what were some of the unpleasant aspects of the early oil lamps? And as we know that some of the unpleasant aspects of the early oil lamps were that the oil in them had an unpleasant odor and they had to be carefully cleaned and maintained so that the glass did not get dirty. Our next question is, what was dangerous about the gas lamps that were introduced in the 1800s? And the answer is, the dangerous thing about the gas lamps that were introduced in the 1800s was that every now and then one would blow up. Our next question is, what powers modern street lamps? And as we know that modern street lamps are powered by electricity. Our next question is, what did the German tourist in London say was the effect of the street lamps? And the answer is that the German tourist in London said that the street lamps made the city seem festive, means lively. Our next question is that how did the introduction of the gas lamps change the work of a lamplighter? And the answer is that the gas lamps did not require the same amount of work as the oil lamps. They were much quicker to light and that was all that needed to be done. Means they did not have to be maintained, no oil, no wick. So the work of the lamplighters was greatly reduced and required fewer skills. This had an impact on the status and place in the community of the lamplighters. So friends, this is all about our comprehension exercise. Let's check out our next exercise. Copy the sentences that are true. Change the ones that are not true so that they are correct and then write them out. Our first sentence is that London had street lamps before Paris. No, London had street lamps after Paris. Our next sentence is that London grew rapidly in the 1700s. And it's true. Our next sentence is that lamplighters work all day. No, lamplighters work in the morning and evening. Our next sentence is, the oil lamps used to give off a pleasant smell. Really? Of course not. The oil lamps used to give an unpleasant smell. Our next sentence is that lamplighters used ladders to climb up and light the oil lamps. and it's true. Our next sentence is that Charles Dickens was a lamplighter. Really? Of course not. Charles Dickens was an author. So friends, this is the second part of exercise A. Let's check out the next part. Answer the following questions with reference to context. The line given over here is the authorities realized the benefits they brought and took over the installation and maintenance of them. And the first question related to this line is, what is meant by the authorities? And the answer is that the authorities refers to the people in charge of the country, such as the city council, the government, the rulers, etc. Our next question is that what were the benefits of having street lamps? And the answer is that the street lamps reassured people and made them feel safer. They allowed people to keep working and entertaining after dark. The next line is that there's no more going the rounds to trim by daylight, no more dribbling down of the oil on the hats and bonnets of ladies and gentlemen when one feels in spirits. Any low fellow can light a gas lamp. Now the question is that who said this? And the answer is that a character in Charles Dickens' book, The Lamplighters. Question 2 is that discuss what each means and write down your answers. So the first expression is going the rounds. It means that a round refers to the act of visiting a number of people or places. In this case, each lamplighter would have a number of areas which they were responsible for, means their rounds. Our next expression is that when one feels in spirits, it means that when one has the mood or inclination. Our third expression is that any low fellow. Here it means that unskilled person. So friends, here is exercise B, working with words. Let's check out what do we have in this exercise. It says that think of suitable adjectives to use with these nouns. So our first noun is lamp. So we can either use adjective gas lamp or bright lamp. Our next noun is ladder. We can call it a wooden ladder or long ladder. Our next noun is streets. We can call it moonlit street or narrow street. Our next noun is work. We can say hard work or good work. Our next noun is city. We can either call it big city or overcrowded city. Our last noun is light, so we can call it dim light or patchy light. Part 2 of this exercise is that with the help of a dictionary and after reading the words again in the passage, give the meaning of each word given below. Also find a very different meaning for each word. Our first word is capital, which means the capital or town that functions as the seat of government of a country or region. And the other meaning of this word is the alphabet that is large in size and used to begin sentences and proper nouns. Our next word is trip, which means journey, especially for pleasure. And its second meaning is catch one's foot on something and fall. Our next word is light, which means natural agent that stimulates sight and makes things visible. And its second meaning is not heavy. Our next word is crest, which means top of a mountain or hill. And the other meaning is a tuft of feathers, fur or skin on the head of a bird or some animal. Our next word is issue, which means important topic or problem for discussion. And its other meaning is supply or distribute something for use. Our next word is operate, which means control the functioning of a machine, process or system. And its second meaning is perform a surgical operation. So friends, here is our exercise C. Learning about language. This exercise is about adverbs. So let's check out. We need to pick the adverbs in the following sentences and say what kind of adverbs are they. Friends, if you want to learn about the adverbs in detail, just watch my video about the adverbs. Right now, we are going to solve this exercise. Our first sentence is, London glows brightly. Here, the word brightly is the adverb of manner. Our next sentence is, the lamplighter could safely rest his ladder on them. and the word safely is adverb of manner. Our third sentence is, lamplighters would put a lamp outside the house. Here the word outside is the adverb of place. Our next sentence is, you could easily get lost. And here the word easily is the adverb of manner again. Our next sentence is, they often became a key figure in their communities. And the word often is the adverb of frequency. Our next sentence is, they light them every evening and put them out every morning. Here, the words every evening and every morning are the adverb of frequency. Our last sentence is, the lampposts were decorated with the royal crest and were looked carefully by the lamplighters. And here the word carefully is the adverb of manner. The second part of this exercise is that make three columns and sort the words out into groups. Name the three columns, nouns, adverbs, normally, and adjectives. So here you can write your columns like this, nouns, adverbs, and adjectives. The words have been given in the book. In the nouns column, you can write the words family, bully, tally, folly. In the adverbs column, you can write the words early, poorly, grimly, actively, duly, barely, fairly, mainly, carefully, and gaily. In the adjectives column, you can write friendly, costly, silly, pearly, hilly, holly, curly, homely, and stately. So friends, here we are with the last exercise of the lesson, that is composition. You need to collect as much information about lamplighters as you can by going through the text again and again and making notes. Next, copy and complete the timeline below for a typical day in your life. Then create a timeline of a lamplighter's typical day. So the first timeline is for a typical day in your life. Check this out. In the given duration, you sleep. And then in the next duration, you wake up, take breakfast, go to school, and then lunch, homework, and playtime. And then in the given duration, you sleep again. Now check out the timeline of a lamplighter's typical day. In the given duration, he takes rounds. Then in the next duration, he sleeps. And then in the next duration, he wakes up, takes his lunch, cleans up the lamps, and takes rounds. Friends, there is a project in this exercise as well. Let's check out. Light in the Night is about the introduction of and changes to lightning technologies. Modern street lights use light-sensitive photocells that activate automatically when light is or not needed. Scientists are developing more energy-efficient, more friendly, and more effective street lighting systems. New technologies often replace and radically improve older technologies. See some more examples below. Portable music player, photographs, data storage method, and sending messages. Do some research on one of the topics above. Now, my research is on photography. Photography has come a long way in its relatively short history. In almost 200 years, the camera developed from a plain box that took blurry photos to the high-tech mini computers found in today's DSLRs and smartphones. Photography, as we know it today, began in the late 1830s in France. Josef Nicéphore Niépce used a portable camera obscura to expose a pewter plate coated with bitumen to light. This is the first recorded image that did not fade quickly. In 1839, Sir John Herschel came up with a way of making the first glass negative. The same year, he coined the term photography, deriving from the Greek phos, meaning light, and grapho, means to write. Photography was only for professionals and the very rich until George Eastman started a company called Kodak in the 1880s. Eastman created a flexible roll film that did not require constantly changing the solid plates. In the late 1970s and early 1980s, compact cameras that were capable of making image control decisions on their own were introduced. By 1991, Kodak had produced the first digital camera that was advanced enough to be used successfully by professionals. Other manufacturers quickly followed, and today, Canon, Nikon, Pentax, and other manufacturers offer advanced digital DSLR cameras. Here is the history of photography. Through this picture, you can understand and see the advancement in the field of photography. So friends, this is the complete exercise of the lesson. If you like the video, just give a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. See ya!